Greetings, fellow lieutenants. Welcome back to Delta Force. This mission that we are going to tackle today brings an end to the Chad campaign with full stop. I wonder if that was sort of a pun that they intended. The end of the Chad campaign. The Chad campaign comes to an end with full stop. The end of a sentence, the end of a chapter. How powerful one punctuation can be. Anyway, I'll stop rambling my, you know, stupid linguistic-based philosophy. And let's go ahead and see what this mission is about. Mission: penetrate the enemy base, designated objective lava, and rescue the hostage. Execution: your insertion for this mission is approximately 490 meters southeast of objective lava. Proceed northwest through your checkpoints to a position on a hill overlooking the CNLF compound. Neutralize any hilltop guards and then proceed into the base to liberate the hostage. Once the hostage has been freed, escort him to the extraction point. You are authorized to eliminate any CNLF forces with the potential to interfere with the safety of the hostage. The success of this mission depends on your freeing the hostage and getting him safely to extraction. Okay, so there's an element of threat to the hostage as well, it would seem. Expected enemy forces. Analysis of all source intelligence leads J2 to believe there is a company-sized force stationed in and around the base where the objective is located. While the majority are expected to be on guard duty at the base, two-man teams will be walking the perimeter outside the base, pretty much what we've faced thus far. I mean, as far as the Chad campaign is concerned, because in the Peru campaign, there could have been like five-man teams, two-man teams, single person patrolling, and like the terrorists in Peru were far more organized, I feel like. But these guys are, you know, like, sort of, these guys sort of have a clearer structure in that regard, though. Anyway, I digress. Although there is no evidence of heavy weapons or helicopters at the base, the defenses around the base are considered significant, so there are quite a lot of enemies in this mission. Now, before I head on to read about allied support, I'm just wondering, now, if we have to escort the hostage back to the extraction point, do we like walk into him and then, you know, literally put him in a pocket, and in the top right corner of the HUD, you guys will see that once the mission starts, where it says carrying nothing, will it say carrying hostage? I wonder, or have they actually programmed an algorithm into the hostage to follow us? Anyway, allied support. Once your mission has begun, Alpha team will be inserted approximately 230 meters northwest of the CNLF compound. They will hold their position until you have secured the release of the hostage. They speak as if we are going in to negotiate. I mean, it is a negotiation, just with, you know, force. When that occurs, they will cover your egress from the base and then rendezvous with you at the extraction point. Apologies, I cannot speak today either. Situation: using the information obtained from the capture CNLF officer and computer, the exact location of the hostage has been ascertained. Then why did we destroy the community? Oh, so that they cannot mobilize forces for support. And we killed all the Padawans so that their forces are already dwindling as they are. I see. The destruction of the C3 outpost and training base leaves the forces guarding the hostage cut off from assistance. Clever. After detailed reconnaissance, I guess that is how you strategize things. After detailed reconnaissance of the hostage's location and exhaustive collection of HUMINT or human intelligence and SIGINT or signal intelligence regarding the disposition of forces guarding the hostage, the JF SOC has approved the rescue plan and issued authorization for the mission. Good. So there are some, you know, allies which are approaching the target from the opposite end, and we have to head towards the enemy through this line right here. So yeah, it'll be fun. Looks like a fun mission. They're like, they seem to be protected by a valley, sort of like a fort at this point. So yeah, I mean, we'll have to see how this works. I wonder if they only included like the extraction phase in the briefing, just for the briefing and the map, but decided to remove it from the actual game. But I guess we'll see soon. Oh, I'm getting a sniper. You know what? If I am gonna get a sniper, might as well go for the 50 cal. Double load ammunition and spec ops. Of course. Let's see, for some reason I feel like this mission is not suited to a sniper. But let's see anyway. Let's see how this plays out.
hostage alive.
Roger, King 6.
Clear the extraction point.
Roger, King 6. Was that so difficult to get it out? Anyway, yeah, so the level design in this level compared with number of enemies, that actually is a little frustrating because it sort of makes you try this game out again, try this one level out again, again and again, and nah, that was not gonna reach that guy. And as you can see, it's like super difficult to reach some of the enemies and shoot them, as far as you know this level is concerned. So yeah, this I think is my 9th or 10th try, or maybe 11th try at this level. Again, a fine example of how you can actually shoot somebody dead who isn't even. I see some folks over here as well. So that guy's dead. That guy's dead as well. Who was shooting at me? I wonder. Ah, there you are. So apparently it's random whether or not the people will come up the hill, or you know they'll try and come down the hill, but like try to flank me from below the hill. But yeah, the results are more or less the same every single time. Usually they end up dying, but sometimes, just sometimes, they manage to kill me in the process. And congratulations to them in such an event. Thus far I cannot see anybody, but as soon as I come here I'm pretty sure that I will find some folks who are trying to exfiltrate the camp and come and kill me. Now, yeah, they came from on top of the camp this time around. Like for example these people here. Previously they chose to use the passage between the mountains. But I suppose I've been keeping an eye on it this time around, so they chose to come from on top of the camp. Good to see you gurgling on your own blood. Is that you? Yes, that is. Stay there. But that technically should not have hit him, but it did anyway. And that is something I've been noticing with this game, is that the bullets work in weird ways. Sometimes the bullets that are supposed to hit don't hit, and sometimes the bullets that are not supposed to hit end up hitting. So it's, you never really know for sure whether the bullets that, the shots that you're firing are going to hit or not. It's all hit and miss. Those two guys in the back will, you know, remain at their respective positions. They will not attempt to come and hamper us. Are those some folks? No, that is a dead folk. Another thing about this game is how it's difficult to see live folk versus dead folk. I'm just going to stick to the bottom of this base right here. I sometimes feel like I probably should have packed a law with me to take out these enemy towers, but yeah. This mission is difficult, no lying about that. This mission is definitely a difficult mission, and most of it probably has to do with the level design and how there are like so many modulations in the level. And all it really does is it makes it difficult for you to shoot the enemy. It doesn't really provide you with as much cover, because as it turns out, the enemies can actually shoot you dead even when you can't see them, or they're not directly looking at you. Now, is there somebody on top of that mountain over there? No, but there are some people on top of this hill here. And I don't believe they are engaging in a flanking maneuver against me. I would like to maintain my distance from this, because as it turns out, you can actually get killed, not get killed, you can actually freeze this game if you're sticking too close to objects. And I suppose the cover system hadn't been invented yet. You're alive as well. Who else is shooting at me? There should be another person over here. Anybody else that would like to take a piece of me personally? That would like a piece of me personally. A little more personally, I mean. Sometimes my English goes bad. I think I see somebody in there. Too bad I don't have my grenade launcher. Otherwise, I could have, like, confirmed that. Like, when the launcher explodes, you know that there is definitely somebody in there. I thought I killed you already. I guess I did not. Now you're, like, definitely dead. What about this person here? Should be a few more people over there. Cool. That you're dead as well. You are dead as well. What about you, though? Are you in there? I think there should be somebody in there. Now, there's apparently somebody running across the ground here as well. Oh yeah, I remember this person. Yes, I do. This person, like, sort of keeps making rounds in between these mountains over here, and then, like, sort of returns every now and then. But anyway, we're just gonna wait for him to show himself, and then we're gonna take a shot at him. Good. Now that most of the people here have been neutralized, I'm just gonna turn my focus a little more inwards. And what I need to be here at this point is super careful. Otherwise, there are some people who could come back to bite my ass. Like that one person over there who detached himself from the squad to try and take me on. Now, at this point, I cannot see anybody over here. I'm going to reposition a little so that I can see more people. There's another one. And what I should be is a little more comfortable, because it's very easy for these people to kill me from this angle if I expose myself too much. So yeah, I need to be super careful as to how I'm exposing myself. Otherwise, it's game over for me. I do believe that person in that tent is dead as well, but you will never really know. Yeah, they're dead. They're dead. Only people inside the ditch here are left, and the person in just a second, somebody is here. Okay, so there's somebody at the very end of the hill. No, I've killed them as well. There's just somebody behind me over here in this direction, and I just need to be careful so that I don't get shot by them. But they seem to be quite far off, I think like 200 meters or so. And they seem blissfully ignorant of everything going on here. So I hope they'll stay that way. Nope. I see you, and I'm going to take your life for that. There's another person that is quite far off, and I do believe I have the leisure of approaching and killing them without, you know, too much of an issue. I do believe I can take cover on the inside of this tent now. There should be a few more soldiers in this corner of the... I would like to stay away from these bunkers, because... not bunkers, what do you call them? Barricades? Yeah, barricades. Because they sort of tend to bug your game up. So anyway, this is the best progress that I've had thus far, and hopefully this is where the game ends, because from what it would seem, Alpha Team is already in mission, and the hostage seems to be located inside of that compound over there. So what we'll do instead of, risking it is we'll just use our grenades and destroy any enemies that we can find inside of this base right here. Not this base, rather this building. I think they're inside this building. I'm not sure, of course. You never can be. Because if you're a little too sure, then you're playing the game wrong. And taking a risk is sort of part of the game. So, yeah, I do think that the enemy is inside of this building and the one beside it, and there should be another enemy inside of that building over there. As we can see, this gives us a warning that that is a friendly force that we should not be messing with. I'm just going to take out my pistol in case the enemy jumps me, and I hope that I do not die while doing this. That person is also dead. No, that person is not dead. There's another person in here. So I suppose that enemy is in this building over here. This building seems to have... seems to be full of... Well, that took care of that. And we just have one final enemy remaining, and I would like to be a little careful when approaching this building. Because from what I can see, there you are. And that should clear the route up until the extraction for us. There are no more major threats at this point. That is Alpha 2 and Alpha 1. Thankfully, they're alive in this run through as well. Let me just take my pistol out, just in case. And so we're...
Get me out of here!
And how do I do that? Like, do I literally just move, or... I would not like to shoot you accidentally, but at this point I really don't know how to interact with you either. I hope that it does not bug out. Are you following us? Are you following us right now, sir? I do believe you are. Yes,
Alpha,
you are.
Alpha, can you see the hostage?
Hostage is running! Moving west for extraction! Bravo, cover him!
Bravo is protecting the hostage. Taking out the sniper rifle again. Just in case things go sideways. I do not expect them to, because... Come on, sir, you need to stick with us. We have taken out most of the enemy forces at the base, and...
This is Black Widow, approaching the pickup point.
Yeah, I mean, this mission run-through was quite smooth. Much smoother than I could have anticipated. I thought I saw some movement over there, but I suppose I was mistaken. At any rate... Oh my
Bravo,
god.
Bravo, prepare to move in. Keep that hostage alive. Alpha team, clear the extraction point.
Roger, King 6.
I zoomed out as soon as the mission was a success, and I couldn't even listen to the ending, you know, statements. So I guess I won't even get a kill count for this mission. They could have really improved upon that, you know, UI design. Anyway, not exactly UI, but rather user input design. So, zero kills, of course, because I reloaded the mission on accident. Bravo team has successfully rescued the hostage. The assault on the base not only successfully liberated the hostage, but also eliminated the last of the CNLF forces. I just checked to confirm whether I am recording right now, and I am thankful for that, because there have been other moments where I have not been live on camera and I successfully completed the mission. Let's hope it does not happen again. Chad armed forces have moved onto that base and taken all remaining CNLF personnel into custody. There was nobody else remaining, except for two people, yeah. Congratulations on the job well done, Bravo team. Thank you very much, Bravo team, consisting of just one person. They should actually be paying me the salary of two people. And I feel like I've made that joke before. But anyway, with that, we are at the end of the Chad campaign. When we come back to the Delta Force, we will kick off the Indonesia campaign, with probably with the mission jump start, since that is one selected by default, and I'm pretty sure that is supposed to be the first mission that we need to tackle. And yeah, we're already halfway through Delta Force. Speaking of, I think I should probably start playing Daggerfall alongside this as well, and see where it goes, because as far as I get a glimpse of the game, it seems to be pretty grindy. Anyhow, that's it for today, and thank you for watching. when we come back next time, we'll tackle Jumpstart. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.